Welcome to another Audible article from MindPower, CenterPoint's free weekly email newsletter. Every Monday, MindPower brings you inspirational articles from leaders in the personal development field, useful tips and techniques to improve your life, plus CenterPoint news and updates. See the links below for more information about this week's MindPower. This week's article is The Most Powerful Magnet for Success or Failure by MaryEllen Tribby, CenterPoint CEO. Read by Ryan Moore. A quote by Mark Twain. You can't depend on your eyes when your imagination is out of focus. Remember old-fashioned cameras that weren't in your phone? They had intricate lenses that you had to focus by hand. The process was very precise and technical, and your results were 100% determined by what you focused on. If you didn't get the results you wanted, it was because the lens wasn't focused properly. One little tick to the right or the left, and you wouldn't have had the perfect shot, right? The good news about that is you had the power to shift the focus and the results of the image. Today, I'd like to explore something that you can do, just like shifting the focus on a camera, to shift the results of your life. We all want the tack-sharp, beautiful, abundant, fulfilling life of our daydreams, right? Here's how to get it. Focus. As a mentor of mine, Bill Harris, often said, what you focus on determines your results. And he was right. I've been using this principle in my life very successfully for decades. And I've seen it happen with other people over and over again with terrific results. In order to get what you want in life, you must focus your mind toward what you want and away from what you don't want. Your brain is a very powerful magnet. It's like a heat-seeking missile, drawing to you whatever it is you are focusing on. And the more energy, vibrance, and passion you conjure up in your imagination, the harder your brain works to make those thoughts a reality. Whatever you focus on most, the failure or the success, the love or the betrayal, the win or the loss, the more situations, people, and resources you will attract to make the object of your focus a reality. The science of focus. This isn't just some woo-woo, pie-in-the-sky thinking. There are scientific reasons and countless studies that prove this out. Your brain has a mechanism called the reticular activating system, or RAS for short. The RAS is a bundle of nerves at your brainstem that filters out unnecessary information so that the important stuff gets through. It's the reason you hear your name in a crowded room. It's the reason you see BMWs everywhere the moment you decide to buy a BMW. It's why red flags go up when you sense something isn't on the up and up, or why you trip on the same pothole every time. It's also the reason if you focus too often on how hard something is, your brain automatically leaps to the obstacles and not the solutions. In effect, it attracts the obstacles rather than the solutions. Let me give you a powerful example. People who know me and my family know that we're all sports nuts. We all play competitive sports and pretty successfully. My son Connor is the quarterback of the football team. My daughter, Michaela, plays collegiate softball, and my youngest daughter, Delaney, is training to play professional tennis. Delaney has won dozens of junior tournaments. She has a great coach and a ton of natural talent. Everyone says she's the next Chris Evert. But she used to have doubts and would get very nervous before her matches. If you were to ask her why that was, she'd tell you that she was afraid of losing. This is exactly the opposite of what she should have been focusing on. Rather than say, I don't want to lose, Delaney is learning to say over and over, I want to win. I want to win. I can win this. I'm going to win. Like a magnet, whenever her thoughts turn to fears of getting beat, of double faulting, or hitting the ball into the net, she starts attracting those very mistakes and outcomes. Just like she trains her body to hit the tennis ball in a certain way to get a desired result, she trains her brain to focus on the ace serve, the cross-court winner, and the perfect lob. She focuses on what it will feel like to win, to hold that trophy over her head, to climb the national rankings. The more vivid and detailed her thoughts are on winning, the more likely it is that she will consistently set herself up to win. Train your brain. As you can see, it's very important that your mind leans towards what you want, towards resourceful thoughts and feelings that serve you, and away from those that quietly sabotage you. Bear in mind that positive thinking isn't automatic or easy. It doesn't come to us naturally. There is a scientific reason for that, in case you're feeling bad about yourself for being negative too often. Our brain, since caveman days, had to be alert to potential dangers in order to survive. We evolved as a species to be highly aware of our surroundings. We were ingrained, for our very survival, to focus on the negative, to spend time, energy, and resources on potential dangers. That's why it's so easy, so automatic, to focus on the negative thoughts that may or may not happen in our lives. But this habit can be changed. You can retrain your brain to make positive, resourceful thoughts and feelings become your automatic response. As a side note, don't feel bad when you find yourself traveling down a dark tunnel of fears, doubts, and what-ifs. Your brain is pre-wired that way. But you can retrain your brain to lean in a new direction, towards the resourceful thoughts that serve you instead of those that ultimately sabotage you. Keep using your holosync and be alert for negative thoughts and feelings. As soon as you recognize them, flip them over. Find the opposite feelings, the positive results, the great outcomes, and aim your brain on those things instead. You will find, with the same powerful magnet known as your brain, that you're automatically attracting good, abundant, and beautiful things into your life. I hope that you've enjoyed this video taken from last week's email edition of Mind Power. Remember to like, subscribe, and share. Until next time, be well.